Hi, my name is Robert Friedman. I graduated Teaneck High School in 1962, and I'm part of a project along with my classmate Richard Pink, who's sitting next to me. We're trying to memorialize what the Teaneck experience means as it pertains to growing up and going to school in Teaneck during the 1950s through the 1960s, and we plan to share what we're doing with all of the other classes for their use also. So as we were saying, it was a golden era in Teaneck, and what are your reflections?
I think that's a great term. I look upon that time in my life and the time that we were in Teaneck as really being a very special time in our country's development. We happen to be, I think, in a very unique and special place at that time. The Northeast in itself was really the center of the country, perhaps the center of the universe, if you will. Our money and capital markets were all there, uniquely so. The entertainment industry had not yet moved to California. We even had some textile industries there. In any measure, it was really the center. And I think Teaneck reflected that in the unique and talented people that it attracted in general. And of course, our school system was among the very best in the country. Now, having said that, what did growing up in Teaneck mean to me? I grew up, moved into Teaneck when I was before nursery school. I was like 3. So that would bring me into the late 40s. So into the 40s, 50s, and then leaving Teaneck shortly after high school into the early 60s. But I lived on a corner across from Lowell School. So I was very closely tied to that group, and we had a really great neighborhood, which is also kind of unique today. I mean, as most of you can relate to, you know, we left in the summers particularly. We left our house early in the morning on our bikes, and our parents probably didn't see us till late in the afternoon or even at dinner time, and for the most part, may not even know where we were, but knew that we were safe. Some great memories of neighborhood kids. They have play dates today. We just went and played with whatever friends we could find, knocked on doors, played in the schoolyards, played in the many, many parks we had. Phelps Park was one that was close to us. So there are great growing up memories. And in fact, I think importantly, I still have many of those friends today that I had going back to nursery school, Copley's Nursery School, which is where I started. And I have dozens of friends from Lowell School that I still keep in contact with and are usually part of these reunion committees. And I think everyone shares a lot of those similar events. But for me, in terms of shaping my life and how I look at things and how I perform in my life, for me, the sports program is really where I center my attention, where I had my most interest. I played football, I wrestled, I was on a track team as a pole vaulter, not a really very good one. But I was active in sports all throughout, and we had some great coaches. We had people that really gave the message of hard work to succeed. And some of the things that stick in my mind today about those programs that, and I think have influenced me in everything I did, was that two sayings that Charlie Gunnar really immortalized in my mind. One was that a winner never quits, and a quitter never wins. And the other is, it's not the size of the dog in the fight, but the size of the fight in the dog that really counts. Now, I was not the biggest guy, but I was a pretty good performer in sports because of those two things. And it's carried through to everything I do. I'm the kind of guy that sees a challenge and people will say, oh, you can't do that for this, that, and that reason. And that is like a spark under me. And it's like, oh, yes, I can.
So basically, a lot of your inner self today really goes back to these roots. I would think, from what you're saying.
Oh, absolutely. And it's those things I just mentioned are very important. But it was also this whole social environment at Teaneck. We had a class that I feel particularly close to, and broad spectrum of people who have varied interests.